welcome back after the tea break. You must be happy that it is the last lecture, but I will make your happiness even more because I am not going to give any lecture at all. So I have converted this to a surprise tutorial because I wanted to tell, no, I am not going to give you any exercise, I am going to do it. Because I wanted to show you how a tutorial is conducted by me when I take students, and I do not make only them to do it, I do it myself and then ask them to do it. So what we are going to do is tutorial on, and what I want to impress on you is that the tutorial has a very specific purpose, just as laboratory has a specific purpose. The tutorial has to bring in the mind of the student that connection between what you have been teaching or what is in the textbook to reality. So reality is that some such circuits are actually used, required somewhere and so on, and I am teaching the theory of it, and now you have to make this connection. So making this connection is also the same purpose as in lab, that you have to make this connection that when you teach a common mode amplifier, the connection should be made that I want to make an audio amplifier, not a common mode amplifier. The laboratory experiment cannot be called common mode amplifier because that is the same thing in the book. It has to be called a audio amplifier. Same way, if I conduct a tutorial, I cannot go on teaching you the theory as the excuse, or I can give you only numericals. I have to make that connection between what is taught and what is the numerical and what are the realities. So I have a few things, and like yesterday you can also have access to this later, but I am going to show you something of interest. So I am going to show you a few illusions. So this lecture will have less jokes and few things like this to make that connection. So you see there are some dots, and I want you to look at it carefully, focus on that center cross point plus. So I have to also do it myself from here. No, appear again because you are not doing meditation. If you do a meditation, it should not come back again. Everything disappears. So that means if you focus on your task, all the other paraphernalia goes away. So that's the important focusing. So what we are doing is to focus. No, that is the next one. Now, no, only one dot moving on the circle. From here it is even better. So the nearer you are to this, the easier it is to focus. The further you are, then the mind plays games on it. Now this one. What is the color of A? Is some gray. The color of A is some gray, color of B is some gray. Are grays in A and B same color? Obviously not. So I did this exercise. I went to Microsoft Paint and with a dropper, the dropper picked up this color and made a rectangle like this and filled that color in that. I took a dropper, I picked up the same color and I filled a rectangle. Now you look near A, it looks perfect, look near B also looks perfect, but A and B are still looking different, but they are the same color. So this is optical illusion. This is real, man. The other one required meditation, you know, concentration and all that. This does not require concentration. This is real, color in A and B are same, appearing different. Why? because there is a contrast, there is a shadow of this green cylinder falling across, and the eye has this perception that it only remembers the contrast, it does not remember anything else. So, if you look at a very bright object and close the eye, that bright object becomes a black object in your eye. You can try that at night. So, eye and the brain perceives only contrast, it does not perceive any real color. So, this is the syllabus of your university, all uniform, and you are all 20 people teaching the same syllabus in different colleges. But the people teach differently. Professor A will teach in this way, so it appears bright. Professor B, same. Professor C, syllabus appears difficult. The same syllabus is being taught. It depends on who is teaching, it appears difficult or it appears simple. The syllabus is same. I did not make any change. I just changed the contrast and it looks different. I can go back one step if you want. Absolutely same. So, you please pick up your style of teaching, make the syllabus contain brighter. So, it is in your interest and it is in everybody's interest that the student get interested in what you do. And what is interesting is, in India you respect only the age, that is why you are all politely, you know, saying that okay sir, sir. The same thing when I was 25-year-old, I will show that, you know, you will hate the fellow. What is this young fellow think of himself? Making a joke instead of giving a lecture, he is telling any other thing. So, I think you all, as soon as you become older and older, you will get more and more respect, which is natural. But the younger faculty, when they face the first year class, you know, they get all the, you know, shouting and laughing and banging table as soon as they turn toward the board. So, they got to be bright, they have got to make the course bright for the student to listen. We become older, then it is okay, anyway you teach is fine, as long as you cover the course, it is okay. So, this is the acute problem. So, Laplace transform in circuit analysis. So, I am going to take this quiz. So, one is how do you do apply Laplace transform to a differential equation, that is the fundamental. Then you take a circuit, so no equations are given, now the circuit is given, and from the circuit you have to write differential equation if necessary and then apply Laplace transform and then solve it. The third one is the topic for today. I want us to realize the question 5A by using op amps, that is the topic of today. So, this is called a long connection to op amps, this is the filter, and then I must make this filter using op amps. So, I will not do the first two, the topic for today is how to make this filter. So, this is a filter. So, S represents the Laplace transform variable and these are the numbers, whether you call it I of S or V of S is the same thing. So, my strategy always is that I have got this written out, so I always ask the students whether they like the answers to model answers to these quizzes, they say yes sir. When I ask you teachers whether you need model answer to the quizzes, you will also say yes, because that is human. So, I do the solve the question A like this, which I am just going to scroll now and I will actually do it with you, but I am little more tougher. Then I say B, please do it yourself. I can't give everything. So, like many good books, you know, they give only answers to alternate problems. Even the numerical answers are not given to the alternate problem. That means the student has to get that confidence that what he has done is correct. If he keeps on checking always where the answer is correct, then in the exam hall, what is he supposed to do? Naturally, he has to ask to the nearest student whether his answer is correct or not. He has no choice, and that is equivalent to copying. So for that also I have found a good way, because here we can set our own paper. So I give a circuit and ask them to do it by two methods. So they don't know how to ask anybody. Answer to both the answer by both methods have to be same. So I think that is a wonderful tactic. In the IIT we survive like that. So they don't have to ask anybody. They have to ask themselves. The method they have confidence in, the method they don't have confidence in, the second method must get the answer which they have got with the first one. So we are now not going to do B. I am going to give you as a take home, later on you can do it. So I am just going to solve this, the first problem, but I don't need the use of this. So when I begin my tutorial, I first give all the theory. So I give all this theory. So this is the summary of previous lecture, so we will skip it. So this is the governing differential equation. So this theory is for the Laplace transform, because I am going to now have my problem was there. I do not remember the exact numbers, but I of s equal to 6 upon s so professor, how far can he go? He only remembers 1, 2, 3. He cannot put anything more. So some textbook have even quite remarkably surprising data like 1 ohm resistor and 1 farad capacitor. I think the fellow who wrote the book does not have any idea how much 1 farad capacitance will be to occupy the whole room. So like that is all 1, 2, 3. So are we going to make a frequency of something 1 hertz or 2 hertz or even less than that? But this is quite popular. Such examples are popular. So we have this equation. So this is a integral differential equation, and then we can have the familiar first year form, you know, d, etc. And then we know how to find the roots using the complex variable. We substitute, we get the formula which is in terms of s. Now this is the most interesting part, is that Laplace and Heaviside realize that e raise to st is the unique and only function in the entire mass known to date, date meaning that 150 years ago, which maintains the form e raise to st under both differentiation integration, and hence must be a solution to any differential or integral differential equation, does not make any difference. And therefore, they immediately use this and came up with this particular form. Heaviside, an English engineer, for the first time used complex variables for impedances of inductances and capacitors, and he generalized the impedance as the inductive reactance of an inductor is S into L, and capacitive reactance of a capacitor is 1 over SC. We know this now, and he was the first fellow to also say that if you have got a AC circuit with a single frequency source in the circuit, what we can do is just substitute S equal to j omega and everything is fine, and the j omega converts all your impedances into the corresponding real imaginary parts, which is called Cartesian coordinates, and the other one is called polar coordinates, the magnitude and phase. So the concept of phase and everything was very easy with S equal to j omega. And Laplace transform was developed, and I do not want to go to the integrity of this 0 plus infinity thing, but it is very easy for me just define, because I assume that the student want to ultimately know what is the advantage of doing that. So we quickly go down. So if you have a f of s, so the derivation just I skipped above is that the Laplace transform of a first derivative with time t is s of f s minus f of 0, which is the initial condition. And of course, you can apply the similar thing to the integral, and the integral become f of s upon s and f inverse of this upon s. F inverse is nothing but this integral. So, it is the charge on capacitor, then it will be a charge integration. If it is a current in the inductor, then it will be the initial current in the inductor. So, now we have a second order differential equation, we will ultimately get this form. The second order differential is s square I s, s of I 0 and I dash of 0, that means this the initial value of the first derivative. Same way, first s of s, s of I s and first derivative, initial value of the normal value, and similarly the integral over the earlier part. The interesting part is if you transfer various terms on the right hand side. So, we have f of s, and if initial condition was 0, this would disappear. If the initial condition of the first derivative was 0, it will disappear again this, and if all integral prior to 0 was again 0, then this will also disappear. So, it will be I s will be equal to f of s divided by this. This is what is our usual relationship if all initial conditions are 0. So, ultimately you get a form which is I of s equal to a numerator and denominator polynomials. The only condition applicable to remember is that the order of the denominator polynomial has to be more than the numerator polynomial, because if it is less then we will get constant term, if they are equal we will get a constant term, if it is less then we will get terms in s and so on. So, if it is equal we get a constant and this numerator denominator, but generally we are given polynomial in the numerator is having higher order. So, let us see, because students will like to know the such things. Suppose I have got a unit step function and the symbol is u of t. So, u of t is 0 for all values less than or equal to t up to what we call t 0 minus and is equal to 1 for t greater than 0 including 0 plus. Now, how do you show 0 plus to a student? So, I have no choice but to draw a graph like this, and the graph has to be drawn in this way, which is a little bit of cheating because that is not correct. This is that peculiar small difference between the Laplace transform, whether value at 0 of current should be taken 0 or 1, so just to differentiate that. At 0 plus the value is 1, at 0 minus the value is 0. So, whenever you have any confusion you must use 0 plus. So, the Laplace transform when you integrate also it is from 0 plus to infinity. So, there is a very minor detail, and the diagram has to be drawn like that to indicate that that 0 plus becomes 1. So, at 0 or 0 minus it is 0. So, you do this and you get it as 1 of an s, that is well known. So, if you have got a input which is in time domain, a step function, then I can actually use that as a Laplace transform 1 by s. Exponentiation, it is 1 upon s plus alpha. So, Laplace transform e raise to minus alpha t, and alpha is this constant associated with this negative exponent, then it becomes plus. So, if it is e raise to plus alpha, then it will be s minus alpha. Alpha is already, the sign is already included. So, when this is minus alpha, this becomes s plus alpha. If it is a ramp function, then it is 1 upon s square. This is all done by integration by part. For sinusoidal, slightly more lengthy, but we get it here. For function of sine of omega t, we get omega upon s square plus omega square, and for cos of omega t, we get s upon s square plus omega square, but we will be intelligent enough not ever required to use this by using the substitution s equal to j omega. So, this is the table, and in IIT we allow all these things for student to take to the exam hall, because we do not believe in mugging up. So, this is called a formula sheet, and then they can carry it inside, and we give 2 marks for a very good formula sheet. There are many words for that, but I like the formula sheet as the best one. All others have an implication of copying and other things, but since it is allowed, because otherwise they keep asking me as a paper setter, sir, it is 1 upon s plus alpha or s minus alpha and things like that. So, I remove their fears by allowing them the sheet, and therefore, we now have such a circuit. And I of s is simply this, and then V in of s. Now, we put whatever is the V in. If it is a unit step function, then we put 1 upon s. If it is anything else, we put appropriately that. So, you see this one has the making of one term having s in the numerator and 2 poles in the denominator, and if V in of s is a unit step function, then I would have got another s here. So, it would have been like this with another s here. So, this particular circuit has got that kind of form. So, I am only interested in demonstrating the form. I am not going to solve this. I am going to solve only the filter application with op amp. That is our target, but this is the background I have to give. Now, there are 2-3 possibilities. One of the possibilities is that I convert this, since you are teachers I am telling you, but students do not know that. I can convert this to something called A upon S, B upon S plus 2, C upon S plus 3. This is called partial fraction. That means, I can find this an equivalent, and this being identically equal to this, I would have got all the constant A, B, C. If I put an identity, then my A, B, C can be found. But Heaviside was a very good friend of us engineers. He gave a very interesting and very simple procedure. This N of S, as I have told you already, includes the F of S. That is, to the circuit, whatever is the input you are given, is Laplace transform also included in the numerator. You remember that? V in S was there. So, that includes it, and this one totally depends only on the circuit. It does not depend on that. So, whatever is the circuit that you connect to the op amp, it will depend on those impedances. So, order of D is usually higher than that of, but if it is equal, we have to separate the constant and then have the remaining part as order here is higher. So, now we have got, if this is S is a single one, then we have got n plus roots, n plus 1 roots, S 1, S 2, S n. So, he said that it can always be represented as a sum of fractions A 0, A 1, A 2, A n by S n. And he could easily give this procedure, and this is one of the simplest, that if I want to find the constant which is belonging to A of k, say second, and all I have to do is to multiply by S plus S 2, this entire formula that I have here, entire formula, I just multiply by S plus S 2, that S 2 term in the numerator denominator gets cancelled, leaving everything behind, and S equal to minus 2, S 2 will give me the constant A 2. So, this is that. A k is nothing but multiply the entire I of S by S plus k and substitute for all other terms a value S equal to S minus k, minus S k, and therefore, it will be very easy for us to find these constants. So, one such example is that this constant is just given as 1, it does not matter. So, now we have got so many terms, and then we do this, we can actually use this as a function. So, if we multiply by S, then we will get the constant A 0, and then we have to substitute S equal to 0. So, then 1 divided by S 1 into S 2 to S n, simple procedure. Having got this A 0, A 1, A n, for this demonstration I do not have to do anything. Then I take the inverse Laplace transform, because this is in terms of the Laplace constant or variable, then getting a inverse Laplace transform I get the time function. So I get the time function T0 into u of t, a1 into e raise to minus s1 t, etc. So I have very carefully avoided any sinusoidal terms coming in, because I want to only use the sinusoidal terms as s equal to j omega and not unnecessarily complicate this. So I think it is a good practice not to complicate inverse Laplace transform with the normal substitution of s upon s square plus omega square for cosine omega t and omega upon s square plus omega square for sin omega t, because that is unnecessarily more complicated. Then there are two additional things. If you want to convert any function to the time domain, then if I want all these, so there is an initial value theorem. So limit t tending to 0 if I want to find for the f of t, but I am not given f of t, I am given f of s. So from a given f of s, how I will find the initial condition time t tending to 0. So all I have to do is to do this left hand side. So set limit s tending to infinity for a function called s into f s, and that will give me the initial value. Exactly similar procedure, if I want to find the time function f of t when t tends to infinity, same s f of s, when s tends to 0, it gives me the time equal to infinity. So therefore, very simple examples I have worked out, but we will not need to do that. We will only need to do what is coming in our example for the. So at the end of lecture, I would have done such a circuit. I actually find applying loop analysis and use here R plus SL and only SL here and like that, and I just put the values and I actually find this for calculating I1 or I2. So I get I1 of S is a polynomial here. Can you see that polynomial here? So I1 of S is a polynomial like that. 12 is a constant, S plus 2 upon S, S plus 3, S plus 1. This is a real circuit giving me a function in Laplace transform. What is the advantage if I go back to circuit? Now I have got the freedom. I can give a time function like this, or I can even give a sinusoidal function, because my function is independent of that. Only my numerator will change depending on what I give as an input. So I already used numerator as 12 of ut in that function, but if I use a sinusoidal function, I could have easily exactly got that function with the sinusoidal one, which anyway I get it by putting s equal to j omega. So I think this example with a real circuit puts the student at ease that they can not only derive the transfer functions and then also solve it using the Laplace transform. You can also do it by taking the partial fractions to find a0, a1, a2. Once you find these constants, then it is a very simple matter to invert it. Secondly, I always ask the student to check this initial value of this by using the initial value theorem and final value of this by final value theorem. And therefore, everything, a student has this problem, I told you. In the exam hall, he does not know whether he has got the right answer. So this is the formula. You do this from a real function, you can find the initial value, put time equal to 0, or put time equal to infinity, you get a final value. You can get the same from the original S function by applying the theorem and both match, then you are happy. So all you have to make is student happy, and in the process you have checked whether he knows both the methods. So both ways also he gets. So even if the examiner does not ask him to apply the initial value theorem and final value theorem, we should encourage them, because this is the best way to check the answer, it tallies. So this is the habit that we have to grow into the student, that they have to know if there are alternate methods to check the actual. So this is the tutorial prerequisite for conducting our. So let us say answer to Q5. So, here is the I of S and this includes V in of S and etcetera, and then we can find this. Now, I am giving you a practice for doing this when I actually want to implement using op amp, I will use this procedure. So, this procedure is 6 upon S, S plus 2 and S plus 3, A0 by S, A1 by S2, A2 S plus 3. So, Heaviside's procedure, A0 is nothing but multiply this entire thing by S. So, S and S get cancelled, substitute S equal to 0 in this. So, we get 6, substitute S equal to 0, you get 2 into 3, 1. Then A1 multiply entire thing by S plus 2, so this disappears. So, you are left with 6 upon S plus 3 with S equal to minus 2. So, this we have set to 0 and therefore, it now remains inside this minus 2 and minus 2 plus 3, that is plus 1, therefore, it is minus 3 and plus 2. So, this is the way we are going to get the constant, and now I have to do this exercise with you because the op amp tutorial I am not going to show you here, but I am going to show you on this one. So, are you with me up to now? So, what are the constants we already got? So, now I go to my good method called create satellite problems, which are very simple to difficult. This is the difficult problem, that is our target. So, the simple problem is, first simple problem, I of S equal to say 6 upon S plus 2. So, make a single filter and we can easily check as omega goes on increasing, this reduces. So, it is a low pass filter and the cutoff frequency is at omega not equal to 2. So, can we plot the Bode plot for this just by visual thing? So, this is let us take 1, I just dislike 1 or 10. So, this is my output I of S. Is 10 log 10 of I of S I. So, now I get this is 10 dB and then this is 1 dB, 0 dB sorry, 0 dB and this minus 10. So, at omega naught equal to 2, I am going to get my point at which it is going to drop 10 dB per decade. So, 10 log 10 I is correct, or should it be 20 log 10? When is it correct? 10 log 10 power ratio. So, what is the log 10 to the base 10? 1 and 20. So, if I go from here with 20, then it will drop by 20 dB. So, it drops 20 dB per decade. So, this is the Bode plot. And this is the frequency at which it starts moving, and then there is a exact 3 dB difference here. So, this is also called a 3 dB point, exactly half power, but we do not want to go to that detail. Now I want to make this using a op amp. So let us revise our op amp basics. Let us call it Z1, V in. So, V in of T. So, it can be any signal that we give, and we do not have any positive feedback, only negative feedback. We are not making any oscillator or multivibrator. So, we have this function, and we are very familiar that this function we only use R and C, very popular R and C. Why are inductors never used in this kind of circuits? I do not know. Anybody know? Well, theory is very similar. Why only everybody takes R and C, not inductors? Secondly, we cannot integrate that easily inside also. Inside a VLSI or LSI, very difficult to integrate a 3-dimensional thing which has got a magnetic field involved with that. But even if it is an external component, they are very bulky and then get affected by any other magnetic component being nearby and so on. So, we do not want to do that. So, here what is the function? Yeah. 20 dB. So, let us take S plus 1, he is absolutely right. We can just to show this, when S is very, very small, I should take this as 1, then what I have written is correct. If I take it at 2, then S very small, it would have become half of that. No, both should now change to 1 and 10. I am telling you from this, as S is very, very small, correct, I get only 10. So, everything on the left of that is exactly 10. So, log 10 of 10 is 1 and 20 log 10 of 10 is 20. So, 20 dB on the left of it. As S become very large, right, as S become very large, say become 10, then I neglect this because that is J10. So, I neglect this, then it become 1. At this equal to 10, this become 1 and log of 1 is 0. So, it become 0 dB, which is nothing but 20 dB down, 20 dB per decade. It will keep going like that. It will cross here at 100, and there is no 0 like that, you know, this is a continuous. Minus 20 dB, minus 40 dB, etcetera. It keeps going. This is my low pass, all rejecting all high frequency. So, if I take 1, then I am happy because everything can be now explained. Now, we take the components, some value C, some value R. So, what is the best way I can actually find its equivalent? I can find the equivalent as a parallel component Y of F. This is SC, the admittance of this, and this is 1 by R. Right? So, we can now invert it. R of F is R upon SC R plus 1. ZF. And for this simple circuit, I will choose this as a simple resistor R1. So, now my gain should be minus ZF by Z1, right. The effective gain if A is more than 10 raised to 5 is So, the gain of this VO of t. So, VO of t, now I am writing in the terms of VO of s, should be equal to minus ZF upon RF. In this case, I only use R1. So, minus R upon SCR plus 1 upon R1. This is RF. So, minus RF upon R1 and SCR plus 1. So, now I compare this with this. All I have to say is C and C R should be equal to 1. Yes. Multiply by? Yeah, correct, correct. Or we can write transfer function as by definition. So, I say by definition is VO of is equal to this. So, if I want VO of S, then I have to multiply it with the input transfer function, I mean input in Laplace form. So, there are many variety that if these numbers are 2, 3, 5 like that, then there is a convenient thing to multiply and divide by C R, then you write S plus 1 over C R, and then we say 1 over C R should become 2, 1 plus C R should become 3, depending on what we need. But I am quite comfortable with carrying it like this, and we can convert everything in this particular form for this circuit. So, for C R equal to 1, I will get this, and I can make this ratio. You remember? This goes to 0, I am left with 1, therefore, RF upon R1 should be 10. So, that is the advantage of actually carrying this SCR together, because SCR does not then depend on the frequency. The frequency goes down to 0, the CR also goes with it. Otherwise, the CNR are outside and then they get also remain here, and then we have to take care of that. So, basically, the design of such a thing will be that R1 arbitrary should be at least 10 kilo ohm. Why we say that? Because we do not want the currents in this circuit to be very, very small or very, very big. So, 1 k is okay, 100 k is okay. So, therefore, I have a range like 1 k to 100 k. I can either begin this with arbitrary, suppose I do this, I know 10 k is a reasonable range, then RF is not arbitrary. RF is then going to be exactly 10 times that, 100 k. So, I already derived that, it should give me a ratio of 10. Once RF is decided in this manner, then CF, suppose this is RF and CF. Then RF into CF should be equal to 1, so I can find CF. So, CF should be 1 upon RF. So, we will get that value. So, this is the process. What we need is 3 values, and what we have is only 2 values. One is the gain and other is this number. It is taken 1, but sometimes it can be 2, etcetera. So, we have got only values given, but we have to determine 3 unknowns. So, the design requires 3 parameters, but we have been given only 2 conditions. So, one is the DC gain and one is the frequency determining. And therefore, one of them you have to take arbitrary. So, I like the student who can very proudly write that I have taken R1 as arbitrary. Or some students say 1 microfarad as arbitrary. Any one of them can be arbitrary, and then we can derive the remaining 2 from that. So, I think it is just a matter of convenience. what can be taken as arbitrary. So let me write, I'll rub this out. So 1 upon 10 raised to 5 will be what? 10 microfarad. Right, the product has to be 1. This product has to be 1, we have said, no? So it will be 10 microfarad. Now we do this. Suppose we have to do all this. I must therefore, for my convenient approach, take this 2 out, make this 0.5, and write 2 outside. I have not changed this one, right? 2 multiplying 0.5 s plus 1 is the same as s plus 2, correct? I take 3 out, and this is 1 upon 3. This become 1, and then I get this 6 out, it goes there and makes it 1. So I have now this 1 upon s plus 0.5 s plus 1 plus 0.3 recurring s 1. So now I have got this in a convenient form. Now I can split this into 3 as a product. So this is my method 1. So method 1 is this is what I call by induction. Once I have shown you how to do 1, the rest will follow. Method 1 is that I will get this 1 upon s. Cannot do that, because this has come because I already inputted the input in that. I have to get this I of s, but if I have the transfer function, this 1 by s would not have come. So the transfer function is this, and for the input being step function, I would have got this 1 by s. So 1 by s we have ideal inverter, of course, ideal integrator like that, but I am not of the ideal. So this normally is 1, which comes here because I have converted the transfer function to the output, and I think for all discussion we are discussing of the voltage. So I now convert the function to exactly 2 parts, 0.5 s plus 1 into 0.3 recurring s plus 1. So now I can make this using 2 op amps in tandem. And the form is same, form is identical. So this is my V in or V 1 of t, then I get here V intermediate of t, and then I give this to another resistor. I take both these arbitrary 10 kilo ohm, and I can easily determine the values, because this is the one I have to obtain here and the function I have to obtain here. So this is called doing it in tandem. They just split this into as a product, but I can also do by method 2, which is convert this to partial fraction. what I have to do is, I have to make this one, we know how to find A, so we will not bother about it. So now I have to make, the function is of this type, so it is the same, my solution is same. So is representing this, we take this arbitrary, then we find this. So I get this function, we can call it v2 of s, and this is v3 of s, and the two together will give me v out of s. So I have another function, I think the rate should be okay, better than that. So this is that v2 of s. This is the v3 of s, and now I have to get them in a addition mode. So this is the summation mode, and then I go to I implement these two and I put it in the summation mode, and of course I have to take care of the number of inversions. So if necessary we can always do non-inverting unity gain. So if there were more than two terms, I should get rid of this if I want transfer function. So for a transfer function like this, I will get that even if you actually have S and then you allow me to use a integrator, it is okay, but normally I prefer one without the integrator, because usually that 1 by S should come because of my input being a unit step function. No, no, no. This is only a going continuously down. So if you have a single fellow, then it will go 20 dB down. If you have got a two fellows, it will go 40 dB down. There will be two cutoff points. So there will be two cutoff points, one here, then 20 dB down, then next point onward it will go 40 dB down. 20 dB per decade. At the second cutoff point, it will go to 40 dB per decade. So this W naught, this can be some other W1 and W2. This is giving W1 and W2. So here is 1/2, 1/0.5 is 2. And the other one is 1/3, but normally we will be having it sufficiently apart so that we can draw the Bode plot. So it goes like this. So this is just a low pass filter with more stop band, you know. Yeah, I mean sometimes there is a requirement that at the double that frequency it should be 50 dB down. So to get that, you know, you have to put this more stages.